mother told me someday I would buy galleys with good oars, sail to distant shores, stand up high in the prow, noble bark I steer, steady course to the haven, you many foemen. My mother told me someday I would buy galleys with good oars, sail to distant shores, stand up high in the prow, noble bark I steer, steady course to the haven, you many foemen. My mother told me someday I would buy galleys with good oars, sail to distant shores, stand up high in the prow, noble bark I steer, steady course to the haven, you many foemen, you many foemen, you many foemen.
What's happening, folks? Thank you for coming by. We are the Kilted. I am Brandon. I am from DaVinci's Alchemyst. And before we get started, I, of course, want to introduce my lovely co-host. This is Chris from Scented Swordsman. Chris, how are you?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me on again, Brandon. Nice to see you, man. As always.
Absolutely. Super excited about today's episode. So before we get started in kind of explaining once again what we're doing today, I do want to take the time real fast. For those of you that are not watching this live, that are rewatching this, please pop down in this description down below for this video. Chris and I are both on Instagram, Chris at the Scented Swordsman. Go give him a follow. I am Alchemisted. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, all that good stuff. And then also pop over to Chris's channel and his YouTube channel and give him a sub as well. We both appreciate that. Absolutely. So let's really quickly, let's pop over into the comments and let's see how everybody's doing before we get into a massive description about what we got going on today. So, Dan, I am not late for everything, Dan. Dan, how are you? Lizzie's here. Lizzie, nice to see you. Taffy's in the house. D'Angelo, what's up? Scott, what is up? If my mic is too loud, guys, let me know. I'm kind of screwing around with the...
Tara says, what did I do back there? Snakes instead of swords? Yeah, there is a snake, yeah. Snake and soon to be another snake. There's still swords. Sword over there.
Snakes are fine. Don't be scared. Yeah. Jonathan in the house. Jonathan, how are you? Tara, of course, here. Russell, how's it going, my friend? Let's see. We got Nick. And we got Mr. Snow. How's it going, John?
Hey, John.
Tony Fragdicted in the house.
Hey, Tony.
And hey, Mia's here. Mia, hi. Thanks for coming by.
It's a good crowd already.
I know. Pretty excited about that. Heather. Heather, how are you? Hopefully you're not having to work too hard tonight. All right. Okay, wait. I'm going to have to pop this on here really quick. Like, let's take a look at what he says.
Oh, wow. Nice. We don't throw people out for speaking the truth, okay?
No, Chris and I are pretty heathen style, so I don't think anybody's going to have a problem with that. So, all right, so brief description. So for those of you that may or may not be new to this particular video, excuse me, Chris and I both love fragrance. We both love adult beverages. So we decided to come together, create the Kilted, where we discuss whiskey, spirits, all kinds of different, adult beverage related items, as well as some of our favorite fragrances. So this episode being episode 2, we decided that we would get together some Irish inspired whiskey. Or rather Irish whiskey, and then some Irish, because it's green fragrances. Now, today is also the first day of the spring equinox. So this was actually kind of a nice kismet sort of situation. It was St. Patrick's Day on Wednesday. So this all worked out really, really wonderful. And beans is that this is the first official day of spring. Happy spring, everyone. Hopefully you're staying nice and warm. I know that it's not particularly great weather-wise where I'm at, but we'll get by. I'm sure we'll be okay. So let's take a look at some of these comments real quick.
Heather asked if I got my package. I did not yet, Heather. My mail doesn't usually run here for another hour or two, so hopefully it'll be by the end of the day.
Oh, hey, Paul, how are you? Thanks for coming by. And yeah, that's a good point. I mean, realistically, so the whole, underwear under your kilt thing. If you've ever been to Scotland or Ireland or anywhere over there in the Isles, when it's super cold out and it's windy, yeah, you need to wear underwear. That's all I'm saying. Like, so that whole thing was kind of a myth. I mean, the whole wearing it regimental or whatever. So most people, yeah, they do wear their underwear. They're killed for fear of
pretty hard right now.
Exactly. All right. So without further ado, let's start talking about the whiskey portion of this. So I want to have a drink. So I'm going to pour myself a beverage. Chris, you want to tell everybody what you're drinking?
Absolutely. So I picked up just for St. Patrick's Day this year, Redbreast 12 year, and it's a single pot still. So my little brother, who is actually also very into adult beverages, suggested that I pick this one up, and he has never steered me wrong, and he is right. This one, I believe, is aged in sherry oak. Triple distilled and matured in the finest oak cask. I believe this uses ex-bourbon and then sherry oak cask.
Nice. Yes, typically a lot of whiskeys, they will do the starting aging in old bourbon barrels.
Right.
And then they'll finish them off in sherry to kind of give them a little bit of a sweeter profile. Redbreast is definitely one of my favorites. I don't currently have any on my shelf just because I've drank through my old, what I had. So, but it's really good.
Instead,
For me, I picked up especially recently. Well, actually, it was long before. I think it was probably around February or January. I picked up Green Spot. So, Green Spot is, here we go. Green Spot is one of my favorite Irish whiskeys as well. So it is distilled under the envelope of Middleton Distilling, which they take care of actually Redbreast, as well as Jameson. Yes, Jameson products. The Spot line, which is Green Spot, Yellow Spot, Red Spot. And I'll tell you a little bit more about this.
You have that one because when I went to the liquor store to pick one up, I had Redbreast in one hand and Green Spot in the other. And sat there for 20 minutes like an idiot trying to figure out which one to get.
yeah. Green Spot in when I went over to Ireland, this was actually here in the States. I know that on the West Coast, particularly in Washington, you can't buy it for any less than like $100 a bottle. Whereas over in Oregon, across the bridge, I think I picked this up for $55 or $60.
Wow.
Whereas in Ireland, it's even cheaper. I think I paid $4 or $5 for a glass at one of the bars that I, pubs that I went to. It's brilliant whiskey. It's awesome. So it is also pot stilled, triple distilled. So I'm going to take a quick sip and then I'm going to tell you.
Is that one, and to the point there that it gets allocated like bourbon, like high end bourbons do here? Like each store only gets, one or two boxes and you can only buy one per customer and it's only certain times of the year where you can get it, that kind of thing?
No, Green Spot's a little more popular now here. So it's not like that difficult to get a hold of. It's definitely a slightly easier one. But I don't know, for whatever reason, they charge a bunch for it in Washington. I'm not 100% sure why. So let's talk about Irish whiskey a little bit. First of all, obviously you can't call it Irish whiskey unless it's made in Ireland. So there's like the first kicker when it comes to Irish whiskey. I know a lot of people think that all Irish whiskey is triple distilled, but that's not necessarily the case. So this one here, Flaming Pig, which I picked up in Ireland. I can't get it over here in the States.
It's a lovely this,
right? It's pretty bitchin' bottle too.
I love that.
I think it has something to do with the story about it. It has something to do with literally there was a warehouse fire, distillery warehouse fire, and some pigs were unfortunately caught in the flames. Irish whiskey, a lot of people think that it's all triple distilled, but that's not the case. I know that I believe Flaming Pig is only double distilled, and it kind of also depends on where you get it. So basically, like Green Spot and Redbreast, they're pot stilled. Mm-hmm. So like in Middleton, who handles Jameson. Now Jameson, the old school Jameson, like right there, that is that's a blend. So it's a blend between pot-stilled whiskey and column-stilled whiskey, which I think can get kind of confusing. So pot stills are like the one that was in the video earlier. Mm-hmm. And then a column still is essentially, for lack of better understanding, it's a column where they have the boiler. And then they have these plates that kind of step so that the evaporate kind of winds its way up and it catches on those collection plates. This is an example of a 100% column stilled whiskey that you could not get in the States until recently, and this is Method and Madness. Now, this is 100% column stilled. You can now get it in the States, so this isn't nearly as special as it once was when I came back from Ireland, but that's okay. So, like I said, with Jameson, it's a blend of that column stilled and then the pot stilled. So, like with the green spot and red breast, you have that pot stilled, and it's triple distilled three times, so it gets a lot of the impurities out, and then it gets aged for however long. And then there you go. There's a majority of your Irish whiskeys, which, by the way, and I'm going to throw this at Jon Snow because he likes to bust balls when it comes to whiskeys. He's very much Scotch, and he's one of those people that says, oh, you can't spell whiskey with an E. Well, that's only Scotch that does that, Jon, because you can see right there, Irish whiskey. You know,
this one also whiskey.
Exactly. So let's thanks Lizzie on the Golden Trunks Award. I appreciate that. Go to some of the comments here.
And welcome, Lizzie and Taffy and anybody else that we missed that snuck in.
That's a good point, Mia. Yeah. Chris has got the Jason Momoa vibes kicking.
Thank you. I saw I'm just on TikTok, as everybody is now, Jason Momoa was throwing axes at this place, and you know, the people came over and like brought him a drink, and he downed it in like one drink, and they were like, oh, well, that's our commercial right there. Just that's it. That's, you know, Jason Momoa sticking an axe, taking a drink, done.
Oh yeah, that's perfect. That's absolutely perfect. So it is little after 1 o'clock here. I am early drinking, technically. I do this for you guys. I really do. I love you. anybody else out there, what are you guys drinking? Are you just going with the old tea, the coffee, the water? I know Chris and I are obviously imbibing, so let us know in what you guys are having some drinks of.
Oh, Jack. Yeah, can never go wrong.
Yeah, that's... It's always a good one. Hey, Amina's in the house. Hey, Amina.
Hey, Amina. And Tara's being boring and just drinking water, Tara. Yeah.
And so is Mr. Snow is just drinking some tea, but hey, that's all right. I also have a sidecar of coffee right here. So
just okay, I've got my Tara drink right here. So oh, and my lovely nails that my daughter did, you know.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
Nice and color coordinated.
Oh, she had a plan. Yeah.
Oh, Tony's drinking a Jamie. Nice. Wonderful. So what do you think about Redbreast then, Chris? You one that you'll keep in your arsenal for a while?
It's extremely mellow and just like easy to sip on. I mean, it's very, very nice.
Yeah, that's kind of the problem with Green Spot is that, I mean, it's so smooth. So smooth, and you can drink it like it's nothing, really. I mean,
I typically would drink it. It's 80 proof, so it is basically nothing. That's not much. Is Green Spot also 80?
Yeah, Green Spot's 80. A lot of Irish whiskey is kind of kicked down to the lower percentage, which is great because you get a lot of the flavor.
Yeah, you do. And,
hey, Nigel's in the house. Hey, Nigel. If anybody didn't watch Nigel's live last night, you definitely need to do yourself a favor and go back and watch it. It was fantastic.
I'm in that crowd. I missed it entirely.
You got to watch it. It was the UK Fragrance YouTube and, well, Fragrance Community Awards, really. Oh. And, oh, man, it was awesome. It was absolutely awesome. It was a long watch, technically, but, man, it went by so fast. And I had such a great time. I had a pretty shit week this week, and it was great to laugh. And there was a tribute that Nige did for Carlos that actually got me teared up.
Oh wow! I'll definitely be watching that back then.
Yeah, because it was Carlos's birthday yesterday, And
I did see that. Yeah.
Yeah. And so that was, you know, it was pretty huge. It was, not to be somber about it or anything, but yeah, I mean, Carlos, just to talk briefly about Carlos is, you know, he was such a huge, huge person in the fragrance community. And I mean, quite literally, he was one of the main reasons that I even started a channel. And he was actually one of my first subscribers before I ever even talked to him. You know, I mean, it was after I started my channel, I kind of started chatting with Carlos, and it was, yeah, he's awesome. He's awesome. And yeah, he's definitely missed. Yeah. I'm
in agreement. Huge personality. A great guy.
Yeah, absolutely. So yeah. Once again, you guys just go check out Nigel's live if you haven't had a chance, because it was fantastic. I mean, it's amazing. Nigel's doing a bitching job. Those every 2 weeks, like clockwork, and I just constantly look forward to him. So, moving on, since we have now kind of talked a little bit about Irish, do you guys have any questions in the crowd about the Irish whiskey? Maybe if I can impart some knowledge that I have just a wee bit of, you know, let me know.
So you're pairing yours with a nice.
Go, your volume got all hinky. Did, I think my earphones might've gone out. Oh, yeah, hold on a quick sec. I think my earphones just went fuzzy.
Did it break?
Oh, there we go. Now I can hear you.
So Jameson has been like really into making their Caskmate stuff lately. And since you're having yours with a coffee, have you tried their coffee Caskmate or their Porter? I think it was a Porter Caskmate. Have you tried those yet?
I've tried the IPA one. But I don't think I've tried any of the others. I don't know. But yeah, they do a lot of different stuff. You know, for example, I have this, which again, you can only get in Ireland. It's the Jameson Distillery Reserve. Like you literally have to go, excuse me, to that distillery to get it. It's, 12 years. And then they make this, which they used to get this in the States, but I think you,
I've heard shipped. Of that one.
Yeah, you can get it shipped, but you can't get it just in the liquor store anymore, from my understanding. Mm-hmm. Really good. It's like definitely an uptick on the original Jameson. So my buddy, when we were over there, he actually bastard. He bought a bottle of gold, Jameson Gold, which they don't make anymore. He bought it for right around 100 US and while we were over there, and it's like $300.
Wow.
Now, so.
Did he intend to flip it and resell it, or just wanted to have it?
He's still got it in his collection. He hasn't opened it.
Good. That's awesome.
Which I told him, like, if he opens it, he needs to holler at me. Okay. So John asks, if you could drink one whiskey, drink one style, would it be Irish or bourbon? That's tough. That's a tough one, John, because
obviously we can't choose. We have so many of both.
Yeah, and being, you know, partially Irish, I love Irish whiskey.
I'm from Kentucky, the land of bourbon, so I guess I'll represent and say bourbon. I do love my bourbon.
Well, and that's the thing too, is like different bourbons have such different flavor profiles.
To me, bourbon and scotch are like completely separate. They have different flavor profiles.
Yeah, definitely. And well, and plus even amongst different, you know, bourbon makers, there's even in the distilleries, you can just do so much to be, God Damn it, John. That's a rough question for me.
I think if John's going to ask these tough questions, he better give us his answer to this in the comments. We need to know.
He's going to say scotch.
Yeah, he is. But I need his justification. I know he's going to say that bourbon is too sweet and, you know, or probably that he's a pansy and can't drink the bourbon because it's too hot, you know, at 140.
Whoa. Those are tough words, Chris. John been called out. Ouch. Yeah, I would say, damn it. I would say probably go with, for me, it would probably be Irish. Oh, shit. I'm not even going to answer. I can't give you an answer.
No, D'Angelo says he's going to throw rye into the mix. And if you throw rye into the mix, that is my personal favorite is rye whiskeys. Those, I mean, if I can find like a good, this one over there is a Knob Creek. It's a double oaked rye. I'd never seen that before. So it's aged in two different oak barrels and then it's a rye whiskey that's finished like that. Never had it before. Super good.
What? He gave you? All right. So apparently everybody's going to Tara's house for a sip of the old 100-year Balvenie.
I just want to know. I mean, everybody's going to ask this question. How low cut was that shirt she was wearing that day?
Oh, wow. What are you implying? Ouch.
That I've never been gifted a 100-year-old bottle, but I've been on many tours.
Well, maybe you need to be a little bit more aggressive with your approach.
I should.
So Paul's asking if I went to the distilleries. I absolutely did. So I went to the distillery in Dublin, the Jameson distillery, which is where I picked up this, the Bow Street distillery, that bottle. Then I also went to the Middleton distillery, where I got a few other bottles. I also went to Tullamore Dew's. There's a bottle back there. That's a distillery only bottle that you can get. And, we had planned on going to a couple of the other ones, but we just never got around to it. We did a lot of drinking when we were there. I mean, obviously it's Ireland, the land of Guinness and Irish whiskey. So
they give you the to-go bottle. Oh, that's awesome, Tara. You know, I think the closest thing that we have here is if you go to the Maker's Mark distillery, you can buy your bottle and you can dip it in the wax yourself, which is kind of cool. I've done that a couple of times.
Yeah. While we were there at the Bow Street distillery, my buddy bought a bottle of the Black Barrel, but it was barrel proof, the Jameson Black Barrel. And he literally pulled it off the cask himself.
Wow.
I got a video of it, and it's signed, dated. It's put in their record and everything back at the distillery. So he ended up selling that bottle to one of our local Irish pubs and they gave him a mint for it. All right. Amina wants to know what whiskey, bourbon, et cetera, you would recommend for someone who is not a huge fan of dark liquors. Well, I would say, honestly, I would definitely suggest Irish whiskey.
Yeah, I probably would too. I mean, it's mellow. It's not super hot. They drink easily. They've got a lot of flavors. I'd say that's a pretty good way to jump in. I definitely would not recommend jumping in with like single barrel or barrel proof bourbon because you won't enjoy yourself.
No. Yeah. And bourbon and rye tend to be a little bit hotter. They usually bottle them at 90 proof instead of 80. Or even up to 100 depending. So definitely Irish whiskey, I think, would be the way to go, Amina, and drink it with rocks, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
Get it plenty chilled. I typically, one of the drinks that I'll drink if I'm trying to have like a night out and I want to drink whiskey and that's it, is I'll just drink standard Jameson on the rocks. It, you know, it melts it down. You dilutes a whole bunch so that by the end of the glass you're mostly drinking water, so you're getting a lot of water back, whereas, you know, like right now I'm drinking neat because I'm just, I don't know, my taste buds, they're that way. I love my whiskey neat.
Yeah, hotter is the throat burn factor, so you won't be picking up any of like the flavors as much, so I would definitely, no matter which way you go, start with like smelling it, try and get a nose on it just like you would with a fragrance, and you know, see what you should be expecting. Because that does help me pick up more once I actually, you know, taste it in my mouth. I can smell like, you know, vanillas or fruits or, you know, that kind of thing.
Nice, Tara. So D'Angelo was asking a good question. Have you tried any sagamore rye?
I have not tried those yet, D'Angelo. Do you recommend them? I think I almost picked up an Angel's Envy rye, but because I like their original Angel's Envy. And that was when I saw this one over here at Knob Creek. It was like some limited run thing that I'd never seen before, so I grabbed that instead. But they have a rare breed rye now from Wild Turkey. Superb. It's probably my favorite one right now.
So Tiggy Girl says to Amina, haven't drank gin in years, but been on a Hendrix kick. Yeah, I like Hendrix. That is a really, really good gin. And they just put out a new one that's, I think it's, might be heavy in a like lavender botanicals. I don't remember. I remember seeing it, but it's like, it looks interesting. It's a little bit more expensive than the usual Hendrix or the usual gin. So I haven't bought it yet because I'm not like the hugest drink gin drinker. So, but I definitely want to try out their new one. So, okay. Well, so I suppose we got to talk a little bit about frags today, huh?
I think there's going to be a sword fight with Tara and Amina. So, I mean, I'm perfectly willing to just kick back and watch that.
What? Yeah. I'm going to put $50 on Amina, though.
I'm going to put $50 on Tara just so it's interesting. And let's...
Because Amina spent some time in Scotland, so I feel like, you know, she probably could kick a little ass with a sword.
So as far as green fragrances go, what do you think of when you think of a green fragrance?
So for me, yeah, green fragrances. So I just kind of this year, I mean, I've always enjoyed some green fragrances, but like this year is kind of like my first, for some reason, I'm craving them like crazy. I've got quite a few in my collection, but I haven't, for some reason over the years, I just haven't got like a bunch. Or haven't worn them a bunch, but for me, green, it encompasses a lot of different shit. So obviously there's like, you know, your minty notes,
right?
To me, fig is a huge player, like the fig leaf, the fig, you know, fruit accord, juniper, it can cover piney stuff, you know, like some of the piney resins, you know, like balsams, like the, you know, pine balsams. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. Fir. Thank you. That's the word I was looking for, like fir trees and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Definitely that. And yeah, so I pulled a pretty huge selection to look at. I mean, I figured we could each talk about five. And then this way we won't hopefully jump all over each other. But
I'm sure we've got some overlap. I pulled probably about a dozen or so. So we'll see
how it goes. I'm sure. I know that you and I both have fairly similar tastes anyway, but I'm interested to see what you have for, you know, give me some ideas too. So before we get started, though, I want to talk really quickly about another green fragrance that just came out that unfortunately us in the States, we can't get our hands on just yet. And that is Scott from Centurion's Legio X. So he, those who are watching the video, if you guys have not seen Scott's channel, I'm going to actually link that down below too. And I'll link to his website for those of you that are in the UK, but he has put out a fragrance. He is a YouTube reviewer. He has a great Insta page and he's super passionate about fragrances. And he on the sly, totally below the radar, I might add, much, much to my chagrin. I had no bloody clue that he was, releasing a fragrance, came out with his own fragrance and it's called Legio X. And some of the main notes are some very green notes. You know, he's got I believe mints in there, tomato leaf, which I'm super excited about because I friggin' love tomato leaf. So that one, be on the lookout for that. I know I myself want to check that out.
Yeah, I definitely do. And I had no idea that he was a secret agent, you know, keeping this, you know, so low key for so long, and it does sound amazing. And he's got a great nose. I love watching his videos, so I'm sure it's going to be great.
That motherfucker is crafty. Like, I mean, how the hell? I wouldn't have been able to do it. I mean, if I had one coming out, I would have just been like, bleh, to everybody. Bleh. Tell everybody about it. Yeah. So how about you? What do you think of when you think of green fragrance?
So for me, when I first thought of green fragrances, I immediately think of more like the pine, like walking through a forest green, like ferns, that can definitely like mostly just pine resins, more like aromatic stuff necessarily than the fresh and clean ones. But lately, especially in the summer, fresh and clean is mint. I mean, that's what you have to reach for. I'm sure we'll both have this one on our list. This is the first one that I immediately thought of was green Irish tweed for today. And, you know, it's probably more leaning towards the aromatic more than the green. But to me, it just smells like spring.
Yeah, that one's definitely, yeah. I think it was it last year. It might have been the year before. I did a comparison video for St. Patrick's Day. And it was a comparison between green Irish tweed and Trey Nui by Armoff.
Oh yeah. Uh-huh.
And to kind of like, you know, see where they stood. You know, green Irish tweed to me was definitely the winner in that, you know, regard. And hey, if you guys want to go check out that video, you surely should check it out.
Absolutely.
I actually spent a bit of time on that one too, so it was fun doing it. But yeah, I don't know. I know that I don't own a bottle of green Irish tweed. My brother-in-law does. He loves it. It never really was my bag. Even like back in the days when cool water was around, I wasn't really hugely into like cool water, but you know, it is definitely still a good fragrance for sure.
So I tried this one. I sprayed this one on paper, like the same time that I sprayed Creed Viking, you know, years ago, and absolutely hated this fragrance. I was like, oh my God, why would anybody want to wear that fragrance? Then I sprayed it on my arm as we were walking out and I was like, okay, oh my God, that is really, really good. So for anyone who is, you know, put off by the opening or tried this one only on paper, I definitely urge you to give it a second try and try it on skin. I mean, I never thought of violet leaf, you know, as a green note until then. And now, you know, that's definitely a major green note for me is violet leaf.
Oh yeah. Yeah, definitely. I think, yeah. And that's a good lesson in general with fragrances, like on paper doesn't mean jack. It's like, you got to put it on skin, like just to see what it does. Unless you're one of those people that doesn't like to wear a lot of fragrances on your skin, just whether you have like reactions or whatever, but yeah, it's definitely gotta go that route. So yeah, no, green Irish tweed is definitely a good pull, but it's not in my arsenal. So, that's a nice one. I think for my first one that I'm going to talk about is, I'm going to go with a heavy hitter and, we'll go with Dryad from Papillon.
Ooh. So I've only seen a sample of that.
Yeah, I absolutely love this. This is the greenness in this. I mean, technically, I think this is classified as a Shipra, but it's so hard to pull individual notes out of this. I mean, you can get some, you know, some woodiness and get some greenness, but I mean, I'm not like the world's greatest nose and describing and picking stuff out, but I have a hard time getting individual components out of this because it's so well blended and crafted. Mm-hmm. It's literally like a Spring Equinox witchcraft spell thrown into a bottle.
I love that description for it. That works.
Yeah, it is gorgeous. And totally unisex in my opinion, you know, and it's just, yeah, definitely one of my favorites, and it's definitely a on the skin type deal. Cause I mean, on paper, it doesn't go through as many changes as it does on my skin. On the skin, it kind of goes through this ebb and flow of like woodiness, spiciness, and greenness. It's friggin' awesome.
I think the only sample of that one that I had was in a dabber, which as we all know, another lesson, doesn't really give you a good feel. So I need to try that one again off of a sprayer. I remember really liking it, but I don't think I really got a good feel for it.
Yeah, yeah, dabbers. I'm not real big on dabbers.
Not the most worth fan. I like that, Lizzie.
Yeah, I don't know that I've tried a bunch of peony.
That definitely is not a note that I'd be able to pick out and be like, that's peony.
Here we go. So Miss Poofer. I love the name.
Oh shit.
That sounds good.
I gotta be careful with how hard I fall back into the chair, apparently, and drop some on my head. That is such a great name, Miss Poofer. It's I love it. And I've heard of Storaskugan, I think, from a couple of different people. And Michelle from Udo Pentagraph, she's talked about them a few times. And I have yet to give them a try. But hey, Peter's in the house. Peter, thanks for coming by.
Hey, Peter.
So what about your second choice? So
my next one, you know, it's borderline green, but if I didn't mention this one, I mean, I just wouldn't be me. And it's staying with the House of Creed, and it's Viking. And as you can tell, I kind of like this fragrance. It's probably the fragrance I wear more than any other. So it does have a mint in here, but it's like a spicy mint. Everything about this is spicy. There's the patchouli in here smells spicy to me. The mint smells spicy. There's also lavender and woody notes and, you know, spicy pink pepper. But I definitely get that spicy mintiness on my skin. So that's why I'm going to put this one as a green fragrance, but definitely a green fragrance that I wear all year long. So
just bringing the Creed power right now. Nice. Yeah. I tried Creed in a boutique. It's like one of two fragrance shops that are in Portland. It's, the Perfume House. And yeah, I did like it. I have not pulled the trigger on a bottle yet. I've actually, between me and you and the fence post, I've been waiting for Matt from Pocket Sense to go stateside with his fragrances so I can get his interpretation, just because when I first heard about Pocket Sense, I was like, oh, that sounds bitchin'. And I had never heard of Creed Viking at that point. So I was like, oh, I really want to get a bottle of this. So that's been on my radar for a long time. And I still can't get a bottle because he doesn't ship to the US yet. So we'll see how
that happens. I'm also waiting for that, because I would much rather buy a second bottle of that rather than a second bottle of this. But
yeah. Yeah, definitely, definitely. Oh, and hey, Andreas. Speaking of mint, he's like the mint master. If I want to think about mint fragrances, then I just ask Andreas, because he's got some great suggestions.
And that he's going to sing back the response to you. So, you know, it's a double whammy, nothing to hate, you know, so much love.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, okay. So another really great, minty fragrance. I'm going to keep this kind of, maybe slightly lesser well known. And that is, Eider Antler from January Scent Project.
Ooh, I like that.
So, I mean, this is literally green. It's,
oh wow.
Yeah. Super, super green. Lots of like mossiness in this. It's almost, it's great to me. I get this kind of like, I picture big ponds full of like algae when really? I smell this, or yeah. And then maybe even just because of the antler factor in the name, I do think about if you've ever been hiking out in the woods and you find a piece of shed that a deer has dropped off in, you know, during the season, that they go through and they shed their antlers, and it's been sitting there for a long ass time, and it literally has moss growing on it. So like, I get that kind of visual when I smell this.
That's awesome.
You know, yeah, a little bit of reediness to it. It's kind of slightly rich. So it's not like, it's not like a fresh citrusy green, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's more of a richer green. It's a good one. It's a really, really good one. Obviously, otherwise I wouldn't own a bottle.
Let's see. If Andreas is going to keep me away from talking about mint for a minute, I guess I will go with this one from SP. And this is Licorice Vetiver. And this one to me is like a green take on licorice, which if you eat licorice, this one is like in the opening, it's like when you open the bag of licorice, just a bright, you know, blast of a bright licorice powderiness. But then mm-hmm. when it dries down, it's like the spicy, green, cool feel like when you're actually eating the licorice. So this one, I think, is gone now. If you can find it, definitely grab a bottle. It is extremely good. I've only had it about a month, and I've already put quite a dent in it. The performance isn't great, but while it's there, it's extremely, extremely good.
Yeah, that's the funny thing about licorice too, is like, I hate the taste of licorice. You know, I've never enjoyed it. I don't mind, like the fennel
mm-hmm.
sort of flavor, which has that licorice, that anise sort of, you know,
yeah,
response. But it's in fragrance, I'm finding it to be a very interesting note. I wasn't really going to talk much about this, but maybe just mention it a little bit, because I haven't actually worn this except for like one spray. But I get the Sense of Wood subscription service.
Yeah.
They send you something new every month, and it's, you know, this size bottle. And this one is vetiver in chestnut.
Ooh,
and
okay.
I mean, this is like as green as you can get. I mean, we're talking juniper oil, French sage, Haitian vetiver, carrot seed, which tends to run, you know, a little bit like rooty and green sometimes. And then licorice flavor extract. And the licorice is really pretty prominent in this. And when I first saw that, I was like, ew, shit, licorice, really? But it actually comes off awesome. It's pretty interesting.
I ended up buying another licorice fragrance after I bought this one, just because I enjoyed it so much. I bought Kerosene Black Vines, which this is like a light, you know, green, spicy, woody licorice. Black Vines is the exact opposite. It's dense and thick and still spicy, but just so much heavier on the licorice. So I do like that one, but it definitely needs to be like a different kind of day for that.
Yeah, definitely. I haven't tried a lot of kerosene stuff, so I need to pick up a discovery kit, you know, as much as I don't need to buy any more fragrances for sure. So I want to remark on this, what Lizzie was saying is, yeah, Lizzie, I also have been really excited about when Liz lets out Spell 125. Super excited about it. Sounds bitching. Claire's take on it was, had me excited. I mean, it's Liz Moore's stuff, so I know it's going to be good. But at the same time, you know, Claire talking about it definitely got me super interested. So I would say, so for my next one, I'm going to go with, this might garner a little bit of like, but I get a certain amount of greenness, a good amount of greenness out of it. I know that everybody talks about how it's, kind of apple spicy, but, Leighton Exclusif.
Oh, yeah.
So, and this of course is, you know, a direct result of bean sprayers, hashtag bean sprayers. Thank you guys so much for this. But yeah, I mean, there is this nice green pepper sort of vibe that I get out of this that peaks through quite a bit as far as like past all the sweetness and the apple spice. The apple spice is bitchin'. I mean, this Leighton on its own is awesome. But when I first tried this, I was like, oh shit, yeah, I got to get this one instead of the regular Leighton. You know, it's good shit. It's really good shit.
Oh yeah, I love that one. I ended up buying a travel set of Leighton, the original one, before I ever smelled the exclusive. And the more I wear it, the more I like the exclusive. And I mean, the distance between them just gets bigger and bigger.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's, I know that a lot of people throw Leighton into the smells like a bunch of other fragrances pool, but I don't necessarily think that's the case, and definitely not with the exclusive. It's just, to me, it's above and beyond anything I've ever smelled before. I haven't had anything like that. I mean, of course, obviously I've had other apple fragrances, but nothing in that regard. So
I like Leighton. It's great. You can spray it on and know that you smell good, but the exclusive is just, it's got so much more depth. It's so much more interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I prefer it for sure.
Oh yeah. It's good. Good, good stuff.
Let's see. Since we've done, you know, you've done a couple that nobody knows about, I'm going to go back to one that everybody knows about. Mugler Cryptomint. So we've talked about some herbal ones. We talked about some, you know, resinous ones. This one is just mint, bright, crisp, clean. I spray this one on every time after I mow the grass. Get a shower, spray this one on, and just feel, grab a beer, you know, probably the third or fourth beer since I've been mowing the grass. And you know,
right.
Something about the patchouli, I mean, just the normal amen DNA mixed with that, you know, pumped up mint is just super clean, cool, and refreshing. Yeah, I mean, I think you can still get this one. If you don't have this one and you like mint, you're definitely missing out. It's great.
Yeah, of course you can't get it anymore though, right?
Is that one discontinued too?
Yeah, that's, to my knowledge.
Well, shit.
It's discontinued. Hey, Robert's in the house. Thanks for coming by, Robert. Appreciate it. Yeah, my understanding is Cryptomint's is
they need to stop discontinuing things. I still have to get some of them, so they need to stop that.
Oh shit. Yeah. Oh hey, there we go. Robert is Guerlain Vetiver is really nice. Russell, I like that one too. I don't own a bottle of that yet. There's a few Guerlains I need to get. Good, good stuff. And Robert is having him some proper 12.
Oh, nice.
Which is interesting. My first introduction to proper 12 was I went to my buddy's place, and it is a collection of a bunch of partially Irish bastards or fully Irish bastards all getting together. We were watching what's his face's fight. Connor's fight.
Connor, yeah.
Uh-huh. And he just released proper 12. So there was four bottles. We're all probably 20 of us standing around watching the fight, and there's four bottles going around, you know, in the big circle. And we're just, yeah, we got a little hammered that night.
But you still remember that how it tasted, which is really saying something.
Yeah. It's it wasn't bad. I mean, it was, I kind of put it up there with Jamie for sure. Yeah. You know, and I was glad that, you know, he wasn't charging like this ridiculous price for it. Cause I thought, oh shit, it's McGregor's whiskey. He's going to want like $80 a bottle or some shit.
But yeah.
No, it was good for it. Who the fuck is that guy? So my next one. Okay. So speaking of, we were talking about tomato leaf earlier. So, this one by Hermes, Un Jardin sur la Nil.
Ooh, yeah, I love that one.
This, I can't quite get the label in that, but whew, dude, yeah, the tomato leaf, the whole garden factor on this is bitchin'. This is one for me that's a little more towards the tail end of spring. It's not so much right now because of like, it's bloody raining outside my door, and I think it might be like 46 degrees. So it kind of sucks right now, but this, yeah, I'm just gonna put a little on my wrist because I love this stuff. Yeah, I don't know if there's mint in this. Andreas, what do you say? is there mint in this? I'm sure you'd know. But the tomato leaf factor is friggin' great. It doesn't last the longest on my skin. It's not super present, but since I wear a couple fragrances in a day, I don't mind so much. You know, I change my what I want to have on my skin throughout the day anyway. So I kind of dig it.
As long as we're talking about tomato leaf, I'm going to go ahead and pull out the one that, to my nose, I always think of tomato leaf, and I could have sworn that it was a note in this fragrance, but as I looked up the notes to get ready for this stream, I found that there's no tomato leaf listed, and it's this one from Fort and Manley, Confessions of a Garden Gnome. And
Lizzie this, was just talking about that.
Oh, yeah. I love this fragrance. It is so interesting. And to me, I mean, this one changes on your skin throughout the day. It's like a journey when you spray this one on. It changes at least 3 or 4 times throughout the day. It's wonderful. But to me, it always smells like tomato leaf. And it's not listed in there. I mean, even from the cap, it smells like you are lifting up the tomatoes, you know, and just like digging your nose in there. That's what it smells like.
Okay. Well, between you and Lizzie talking about that, I'm just going to fucking buy a bottle.
It's so good. I mean, I've got several fragrances from Fort and Manley, and this one might be my favorite. It's so good.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see, I've had my eye on that for a very, very long time when I first heard about Christ, what is his name? Rasazi Fort?
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
The perfumer. Yeah, when I first heard about him, like in that brand, I was just like, okay, this looks pretty interesting, sounds really interesting. And yeah, I've looked at a couple. I think I've tried the amber one that he did, which was friggin' phenomenal, but yeah, I could never find absolutely. Yeah, I could never find like a cheaper price on it, but sometimes, you know, there's quite a few that I don't get from discounters. I just pay full cost. And then, mm-hmm. Yeah, Rasé Fort. Thank you, D'Angelo. Yeah. So
I like the amber one, this one. And I like, the really 40 Thieves. I almost grabbed 40 Thieves for this because it is like the most herbal fragrance that I have. So to me, herbal kind of takes a green feel too. So 40 Thieves is also good. When I sprayed this one on my skin, it kind of smells like you took this one and threw it into the dirt with some tomato leaves, kind of.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice, nice. Love that. Let's see, moving down the line. Oh, this is going to be one that will be interesting to some people that probably haven't heard about it, but I get a lot of greenness from this. I get green and I get pepper. And I get some wood, and I get a little bit of like dirty earthiness. And that is Girl by Pharrell Williams and Comme des Garçons.
Ooh.
Yeah. I don't know if you can still get this anymore, but dude, it's nuts. Like I got this, I picked it up. It was on like a discounter. I think it was cheap as shit. You know, I think it was like 15 bucks or something like that. And yeah. So that makes me think that they probably stopped making it or whatever. But I know Tony picked this up based on Brian from No Notes. And like, cause he talked about it a little bit, I guess. And I was pretty blown away by it. You know, I mean, technically it's my first Comme des Garçons and only at this point, but yeah, it's got this spicy, like peppery green feel that is perfect for spring, you know, really, really good. There we go. Nick says you can get Girl on eBay for 13 bones.
Nice. Don't you love it when you can find something for that cheap that you actually get some use out of? I mean, that's just amazing.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Aaron is in the house.
Hey, Aaron. All right, let's see. Next one I'll pull out is, you know, the Wolf Memo Russian Leather. So this one goes back to more the piney type of green fragrance. So to me, this one is like the fall winter version of this one for me. Like I wear this one in the spring. I wear this one in the fall winter when, you know, I want to feel like I'm, you know, wearing a nice heavy leather jacket, walking through a pine forest, you know, that's what this one smells like to me. It's woody, it's leathery, but it's got so much pine and just greenness in it that it's so, so good. And this one lasts forever on my skin. If I spray this one, I'm probably still smelling it the next day. And I mean, look at that. It's got a wolf howling at the moon. What's not to love about that bottle? I mean, come on.
Yeah, Memo, they make some really sweet bottles. I haven't tried a lot of their stuff. I really like African leather.
Yeah.
I know that that's, it seems like that's a divisive fragrance. It seems like some people really love it. Like, I love it. I don't have a bottle yet, but I love it. Some people are, oh, it's played out. It sucks, blah, blah, blah. You know, I haven't gotten a bottle of it yet, kind of purely based on the fact that I'm trying to like not spend a bunch more money. But then also, my girlfriend hates it. Like, we both tried it during Scent Explore, and yeah, she was just like, oh, that smells like shit. It's like, all right, well, I got a bottle. I'm just going to have to
wear it. Have you tried Italian leather?
I have not.
So to me, African leather is like a lot spicier, and Italian leather is just like a smooth, earthy leather. And I have been wearing the shit out of that one like the last 2 months. It projects off my skin. It's not, I mean, I wear it in the van with Hill, and I mean, it doesn't run her out. She says it smells good every single time I wear it. It just smells amazing. It's like smooth, classy. It's really, really nice. I think since it's earthy enough, I think you might dig that one maybe more than African.
And then I don't know if I've tried Lyric Man, Jonathan. I might have a decant of it floating around somewhere.
I have the bottle back here somewhere. I just didn't grab it for this one, Lyric Man.
No.
Well, let me grab it. I'll see if it's got
a sniff on it. See if it's got green banana. And then Irish leather would have been perfect for this, I guess, Nick.
Yeah, that's the one that's on my list next to get.
Irish leather?
Yeah, Irish leather's next. That one's Italian leather. That one's also good. Let's see. There went original vetiver, but here's Lyric. Rotten banana, really? I'm going to spray this one and see. This one's just a heavy rose fragrance to me, John. Like a nice, smooth, like sexy rose, but I mean, there's some citruses in the opening. I'll see if it dries down to a banana-y, green banana fragrance. We'll see. Pocket scents. Lucky bastards.
Oh, that's right. They don't ship over here.
No, they don't.
Shit. Though, you know what? I mean, we can't, like, can't bust balls too much on not being able to get certain UK stuff. Because I tell you what, my next one that I'm going to bring out is one that, well, not only can you not get it in the US or in the UK because it's from American Perfumer, but you can't get it anywhere else now because it's a limited. And that is Colorado from, it's Don Spencer Hurwitz and American Perfumer. They did some limited releases, you know, only 50 bottles. This was 2020. They did an original one a while back, and then they did a re-release, but this has got that real resinous green piney feel to it. Yeah. Like, I haven't really spent any time in Colorado, but I've been told that a lot of people feel like this is like a flat out super photorealistic interpretation of like being up in the woods in Colorado. And, this definitely, I get a lot of like Oregon hikes, like going out and hiking in Oregon, some dryness to it. Some great green, great, great, great piney green notes in it. And it's really fantastic. Again, sorry that I'm like, oh, I have this and you can't. But yeah, it's one that I really, really enjoy.
Let's see. All right. Well, the next one I'm going to go with is also in like the, you know, the foresty type green. And it's this one from House of Oud. And this one is Cypress Shade. As you would imagine, it's heavy in cypress, but it's also got like a really fruity kind of feel. Like, I know it has like a note of mango, but I can't really pick out the note of mango. I just pick up like fruity sweetness. And it's got like one of the best atomizers in my collection. It's just, you know, like just so fucking nice.
Wow.
But yeah, this one is like a... It's not like a heavy walking in the winter type. Hey, Maya, welcome back. It's not like a heavy walking in the, you know, in the snow through a coniferous forest. This one's more like a sunny day, you know, light, fresh jaunt on a, you know, on a hike to a picnic or something. That's what this one is. Definitely good. I don't know if it was worth the money that I paid for it, but it was. It's definitely nice.
Oh, House of Oud's pretty spendy, huh?
Oh yeah, I think I got that one on a sale at a discounter or something. It was still like 180. Yeah,
that's bucks. Super, super bucks.
Could I show the bottle of Lyric again? Sure.
See.
Oh, that's where it says Lyric. It's all the way up at the top. See if I can get the focus there.
I still don't have an Amouage in my my collection. I mean, I like quite a few of them. I think I'm kind of holding out to see if Meander drops in price a little bit because I really liked that release, that newest one.
I think the only ones I have are that one and Sunshine Man right there, and Hill gave me a bottle of Interlude Black Iris, which that one is
extreme. Oh shit!
Oh yeah, that she gave me that one for Father's Day. Yeah.
Oh nice.
Yeah. Nice. I watch Finn so much, and you know I'm the biggest father figure he has. So yeah, she gave me that one for Father's Day. She blind bought it and hated it. So she's like, here, and oh, it happens to be Father's Day, so we'll say it's Father's Day.
Hey, that's okay.
Yeah, you know. It worked out.
It's a gift. Yeah. Okay. Well, I want to go into some fig a little bit.
Okay, cool. Let's get some fresh greenness in here.
Yeah. So, Kieran NYC, have you had much experience with these guys?
I smelled through a sample set, but I don't have any bottles from them yet.
Okay. Yeah. I think I checked these guys out even before I started my YouTube channel. I don't remember, but I love, I kind of love the ethos behind the brand. They're, you know, just like super self-sustaining sort of, try to being like green and cruelty free as possible, that sort of thing. And they're, watch out, buddy. Careful, dog's catching his ear on my
toast. I remember everything that I smelled for them being like smelling super high quality, super well done. I mean, I liked everything. I just never decided on a bottle.
Yeah, it's I think I have three. I think my first one was Nitro Noir, and then I have Sunday Brunch, which I really dig. It's definitely a great summer frag.
Yeah, I remember
on the lighter side, but. Yeah, 10 a.m. Flirt is, for me, the green fig that's in this, and it's kind of a multitude. It's, you know, green fig, but it's also, like, kind of like the fruity accord on the fig a little bit, and there's some good sandalwood in this.
Ooh.
And I definitely, I don't know, I want to say there's some other woody notes that are a little bit more substantial, because, like, for me, sandalwood is kind of it can be airy a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Or kind of have like that creamy texture.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So, I mean, I love a good sandalwood fragrance, but for me, I prefer sandalwood to be a little bit more in the background because it, for my nose, for some reason, it can take over a fragrance and it's like, oh, well, shit, that's all I smell. I might as well just put sandalwood on. I don't know what that's all about, but for some reason it does. But this one is really well blended out. And yeah, it's good. This 10 a.m. Flirt. I don't know if I mentioned that or not, but yeah.
10 a.m. Flirt. That's a cool model too.
Yeah, they kind of have that whole New York aesthetic going on with their design and whatnot. And this was originally called Highline Flirt, but for some reason they changed the name. I'm not particularly certain as to why. And when I was in New York, I full on recorded a bunch of footage of me up on the Highline with an absolute totally had planned on doing a review of this with that footage. I still might, you know, if I ever get off my ass and do more YouTube videos. I've been slacking. I haven't done one in like 3 weeks. So
I'm not one to talk about that.
Yeah. You are a slacker on that regard, sir, for sure.
But I can tell you about a very inexpensive green fragrance that I have in my collection, and it's this one from Etat Labor d'Orange, and this is You or Someone Like You. And this is probably one of the like the brightest, easy reach fragrances that I have for spring summer. It's, you know, bright, you know, bergamot, you know, grapefruit, everything like that. It's got anise in it, which kind of gives it a little bit of a a little bit of a kick. Tear. I have released one video. I think I have two more that I have recorded, and I need to edit and put out. But I do. I only released one video. I have put more on Instagram, Tara. Anyway, thank you, Tara. You or someone like you, extremely bright and green and just easy to wear. Doesn't last for shit, but it's definitely one that if you need a fragrance just to keep around, it's very good.
Is it pretty insubstantial on you?
Yeah, it doesn't really project at all, and I think I burn it off in like 3 or 4 hours, so it doesn't last forever. But while it's there, I mean, if I go looking for it, I can smell it, and you know, I think I smell fresh and clean when I wear that one, so it's nice.
Yeah. I get a pretty decent wear out of it. I think I probably get around 4 to 5 to 6 hours, depending.
Really?
So, yeah. Yeah, it's, I felt kind of lucky because I think a lot of people have talked about they don't get a lot of lasting power with it. But
I mean, the bottle's so tiny and cute. I just bring it along and just spray it again. It's no big deal.
Yeah, I do love that they have a lot of their fragrances in these. This is a 30, isn't it? Yeah, in the 30. Oh, because I have like 6 by them, and if they were all only in like 100 or 50, I don't think that I would, because too many fragrances in my collection. So yeah, that's a good one. I dig that one for sure. Speaking of slightly light, but yeah, I don't have a full bottle. I have the travel spray of Soft Lawn.
Oh yeah,
From Imaginary Authors. So this is, it's interesting. So if you go through the whole story behind it, you know, with the packaging, and the, you know, imaginary author and the imaginary book that's written about this, you know, the fragrance is based on. So it talks about tennis courts and tennis balls. So I did a review on this when I first started. And to me, I don't really get tennis, probably because I don't play tennis, but I get golfing. Specifically, really? The cheaper 9-hole par 3 golf courses that I tend to go to, as opposed to the big giant bastards, because they have like this mat that you tee off of. You don't really tee off of, you know, the grass or whatever. And yeah, it's got a little sandalwood in it as well, but there's some really fresh grassy notes to me in this, as well as you know, just the general green feel. Have you tried Soft Lawn?
I have. I got it just in like my discovery set or the short story, whatever. And it to me, it smelled exactly like when you first open up a new can of tennis balls and just like dig your nose in there. That's exactly what that one smelled like to me, which I really like that smell, but I don't know that I would want to spray that one on my skin and walk around in public with that one. It was super realistic and I enjoyed it, but I didn't buy a bottle of that one.
Oh yeah. I think some people aren't into it that much. I don't know. I'm a spaz for imaginary authors. I just love the creativity. And so
they're amazing. I do love them.
Yeah. I think I own pretty much most of them.
Yeah. I was just standing here, you know, in my kilt watching our intro and just drooling over your collection of imaginary authors on top of your cabinet there. I was like, you know, he really is an asshole.
Thanks. How dare I spend my money? I do. I think I own every single one except for Every Storm a Serenade, and then one or two of his that he released before I'd ever heard of them, and I could never get my hands on them, you know?
Yeah.
So. Yeah. It's a thing.
All right. So I'm going to stick with, you know, bright and easy to wear and citrusy. And this one's from Parfums de Nicolai. Low Mixty. I don't know if many people have tried this one, but this one is like low L. If it all focused, you'd be able to see Low Mixty, M-I-X-T-E. I don't know why the X quite so big. It's not X rated, I would say. Very easy to wear. But this one is mostly a lemon fragrance. We're all assholes. That's right, Aaron. I definitely agree. Me especially. I say it with love. But this one is mostly a spicy lemon fragrance. It does have mint and bergamot and maybe some sort of woodiness in there, but mostly on my skin, it's just a spicy lemon, but it's one that actually lasts a while. I've got whatever that one is, Chanel Allure Homme Extreme, Allure Homme Edition Blanche, which is a lemon fragrance, a creamy one. This is like a spicy one and lasts like at least twice as long. So low mixty is a good lemon fragrance.
They Nikolai does the, it's fig tea, right?
Yep.
Yeah. I like that one a lot.
Yeah, that one's also really good. I don't have a bottle of that one. I think Hill has that one.
Yeah, I thought about pulling that, but again, I didn't want to pull like just a shit ton of everything off the shelf and bring it out here because I was trying to keep this light on the timeline. We got about 15 minutes left, tops.
Okay, cool.
You know, roll it out. Let's see. Ooh, I do have, so speaking of like piney, when we talked about pine earlier and imaginary authors, Cape Hardick. So yeah,
indeed.
That is about super, super green to me. Like this is one of those, I mean, there's definitely that strawberry that comes out in the very beginning.
Mm-hmm.
But the pine needle-ness in this is friggin' awesome.
I call that the Christmas tree-ness on this one. It just smells like strawberry Christmas.
Yeah, yeah. It's really bitchin'. This reminds me a lot of the Pacific Northwest for sure, as far as like going out and hiking in the middle of all the pine trees. Yeah, totally good shit. Very, very good shit. So before we keep rolling down the line a little bit, how about everybody in the chat? Why don't you guys talk about what you think of when you think of green fragrances?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Chris, I will let you roll through and do your thing. I'm going to hit the head. Okay. I'll be back.
Sounds good. All right, so you guys go ahead and tell me about some green, what you think of with green fragrances, and I'll tell you about a not-so-popular one that I think of as a green fragrance. This one is from M. Mikalev, and this is, if it will focus, Royal Vintage. And the thing about this one is that it has like a pineapple opening, so everyone compares this one to Aventus. They say that this is Mikalev's attempt at Aventus. But to me, it's like a green take on Aventus, which is my favorite take on Aventus. So I own this one, and I don't have Aventus. This is a very woody, probably more aromatic than green fragrance. But to me, it comes off, you know, cool and green. So I'm going to list it here in this one anyway. And I haven't had a chance to talk about this one. So Royal Vintage from M. Mikalev. I think they changed the bottle. It doesn't look like this anymore. But it's extremely good. Let's see. So somebody tell me about some green fragrances that you like or what notes that you think of when you think about a green fragrance, or I'm just going to keep pulling them. I've got more fragrances to talk about. Aventus. I think I would have to kick myself in the nuts if I said it that way, Tara. Let's see. I just got Willow from Skylar. Smells like leaves, moss, and grass. That sounds good. Heather, you think of Cypress Shade. You're very, very, very welcome for that. There's the bottle in case you want to drool over it, Heather. Let's see. Tiger Girl says, I'm not a huge fan of green fragrances for myself. They smell better on a guy, in my opinion. Okay, that's fine. You know, Tara, I didn't bring a single fig fragrance, and I don't know that I have a single fig fragrance. I think if I have ever bought a bottle of a fig fragrance, Hill has taken it from my collection because that's probably one of her favorite notes. And I don't have anything fig. Nothing fig whatsoever. So, Hill, if you're watching, stop taking all the fig fragrances. Let's see. Grass by Lush is a... I have not smelled that one. Chanel number 19. Let's see. Yeah, I'm going to have to get some fig. Let's see, Tara also thinks of green vanilla.
Your mic just went tits up, Chris. Still tits up. There we go.
So yeah, Ani is a green vanilla fragrance, but Architects Club is also a green vanilla, and I almost grabbed that one for this, but I only have a travel thing of it, so I didn't grab that one.
Oh, Heather, I've been wanting to try that out because that's like got a little bit of a tea element in it, right?
Ooh.
That's one from Nishane that's like trying to decide between that one and 100 Silent Ways.
I love 100 Silent Ways. That one's really good.
So I switched to beer. Smix, the official beer aside from Guinness of St. Patrick's Day.
Smithwick, are they the ones that make a beer with pine needles?
Smittix? No.
No,
not that I'm aware of.
Somebody made a beer with pine needles that I tried at one point. I don't remember who it was. Tasted like absolute garbage, but it was made out of pine needles, so it was worth trying. Let's see. So I talked about a green Aventus while you were gone.
Saw that.
Let's see.
Saw that. I have. So this, I think, is discontinued as well, but you can get it for cheap on discounters. Issey Miyake Lou Blue Deissey. Now, it's going to throw you off because it's a blue bottle, and you're going to think, oh, it's blue. It's so bloody well not blue. This is so green. Like, I originally was thinking about getting just the original Lou Deissey, but... you know, and that one, it's got some nice green notes to it, but it's predominantly citrus for me, citrus and woods. But this has got some great greenness. I have no idea why they called it Le Bleu d'Issy, because I think everybody automatically, like I wasn't going to touch this because I'm not real big on blue fragrances. Sauvage, you know, Bleu de Chanel, that sort of shit. That's not typically my bag. And so I didn't go anywhere near this, but then I saw Chad from A Gentleman's Journey. He did a video on this and he talked about it being green. And I was like, well, shit, it's like $15 on fragrancebuy.ca. So I snagged it. And yeah, I'm glad that I did, because this is great for spring, summer. It's got a little pepperiness to it. Some nice green. I don't know what the green notes are in it, to be honest, like breakdown wise, but I wouldn't be surprised at all if there was a little violet leaf in this.
Seems like most of the ones that I gravitate towards have either, you know, pine or violet leaf.
Hmm. Gotcha.
I will confess that I don't have any Issey Miyake's, and I don't know that I have ever smelled Issey Miyake fragrance.
Really?
I've seen them in like department stores and things like that, and I don't think I've ever stopped and smelled them. I should remedy that.
I bought the OG specifically because Tony wore it on his wedding day.
Hmm.
And it sounded interesting. It was cheap. I bought New EDSE a long time ago. And so I love that, the Eau de Parfum. But like, I really had no intention ever, but then Tony talked about it so you know, lovingly, of course, because it's his wedding scent, and I thought, well, I'll give it a shot and see what it's like. And yeah, I like that one quite a bit. It's good. And then I just picked up the Noir Ombre, or the one that like nobody can get anymore. It's an amber. It's good. It's smoky.
I almost blind bought the one that had so much hype, the Pulse of the Night. I almost blind bought that one, but it just kept going out of stock. And after like the third time of going to look for it, I was like, screw it. No big deal.
Yeah. I'm sure it'll come back.
Oh yeah. It's probably there now. I haven't looked in 6 months.
There we go. Jonathan was talking. There we go. Yeah. Noir Ombre from Issey Miyake.
Okay.
Yeah. That one is like, for the last 2 years, I've been looking for it and couldn't find it anywhere. And then it finally popped up again on fragrancebuy.ca, and snagged that. So
that's just the best place to order. That's why where I get most of my things. Jonathan, yeah. Wolf of the Night is gorgeous. So the hype continues. I'm going to have to get it. And if it's bad, I'm going to blame John.
Well, you know, John does like you. I'm kidding, John. I'm kidding. You know, the other day I almost bought some Youp flankers just because I want to like see what else they've got aside from the original.
I mean, if they're all, you know, $30 and under, why not, you know?
Yeah, no, that's true. They are all pretty cheap. And didn't they, John, didn't Youp just do a new release recently? Did I hear something about that down the pipeline, or am I crazy?
I haven't heard about that one.
Yeah, I thought I'd heard something about them doing
something. I'm not in the know. If it's about books, yeah, I probably would have heard about it, but not so much on all the fragrance. Joop Absolute. Okay. I've not smelled that.
All right, drive safe, Russ. Thanks for stopping by. And yeah, definitely drive safe, my friend. I think we're getting pretty close to buttoning up anyway. So
yeah. You have any other fragrances that you wanted to mention, Brandon?
Everything's back in the room right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and just call that a live stream. Man, we gotta get your mic fixed.
You know, what is it doing?
Okay. I don't know. Is your cord plugged in properly, or
it's attached to my camera?
Oh, it's on your okay.
Yeah, it makes no sense why one would go out and not the other, but it's okay.
Maybe it's so the maybe only it's other one. Get one of these.
Well, I'm gonna have to. The only other one I grabbed was Original Vetiver, just because. I mean, look at that bottle. The bottle's green. I mean, so take a hint, Issey Miyake. If you're gonna have a green fragrance, put it in a green bottle. You know?
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
So this one, I mean, everybody knows that one. It's just highlights vetiver. It's grassy. Very, very nice for spring.
And apparently Chris's unofficial sponsor is the unofficial sponsor of Creed. Which, hey, you know what, Creed? If you guys want to sponsor us to do our live, then fucking please.
Yeah, you can definitely pay me in Viking, you know, just...
Yeah, or just toss a couple frags our way and I'll tell you what I think. I'm going to be honest about it. If it's Aventus, I'm going to tell you to eat it, but whatever.
If it's Aventus, I'm probably not going to open it and then sell it for a lot more than it's worth.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
Spice and Wood, I'll definitely keep that. I love that fragrance.
Which one?
Spice and Wood.
Oh, yeah, I've heard good things about that. I want to try Bois de Portugal.
That one is really good. I feel like that would be up your alley for sure.
Yeah. 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 That sounds pretty decent. So, well, folks, thank you guys very much. I think we're going to wrap things up now. We're right close to that hour 30 mark. So looks like a good spot. Yeah. Just time flies when you're having fun talking about whiskey and frags for sure.
It sure does. I didn't know it'd been an hour and a half already.
I know. Right. So just to reiterate, Chris and I plan on doing this like once a month at least, possibly even every 2 weeks, depending if we can, you know, get our personal shit together. Actually, I shouldn't say that about Chris. It's me. I'm far too swamped with life lately, but it would be fun to do this twice a month. Sure. So yeah, if you guys have any, you know, any stuff you'd like to see us focus on. I do believe that Chris and I have talked about the next episode. It would be episode 3. We are going to actually do a mixed cocktail for you guys. Yes. And I do believe I will set everything up and figure out a way to set it up over in my kitchen so that I can have my bartending set up right there so we can actually just do a cocktail tutorial for the start. So, yeah, and we'll see what we get going for next episode's frags. Please feel free to drop us any kind of a suggestion, whether it be in the comments of this after it gets done posting, or if you guys, you know, DM us on Insta, that we're definitely open to suggestion.
Absolutely. And we really appreciate everybody hanging out with us. It's been a great time. We always look forward to the next one. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you guys very much. And I hope you have a fabulous rest of your weekend. And yeah, keep yourselves entertained. And I hope whatever it is you're drinking, that it's delicious, whether it be an adult beverage or just something as simple as tea. And hope that hope to see you guys in the next broadcast, Chris, my friend, and look forward to the next one.
Thank you, guys. Bye.
Peace.